Thank you, Madam Chair, Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, warm greetings from India. At the outset, I would like to thank the Secretary General, His Excellency, Mr. Hu Linzhao, for presenting a well-analyzed and informative report for the 6th World Telecommunication Policy Forum. Telecommunication and ICT have emerged as the foundations of the global economy, and more importantly, during the challenging COVID-19 pandemic. I wish to place on record the enormous contribution of ITU in the promotion and development of telecommunications and ICTs. Your Excellency, Madam Chair, telecommunications and ICTs are crucial tools for enabling inclusive growth and stimulation of national economies. India is home to over 1.2 billion telecom subscribers with one of the lowest mobile tariffs. Government of India is implementing BharatNet, one of the world's largest rural optic fiber network, aiming to connect nearly 600,000 villages with broadband, facilitating digital inclusion and empowerment. India's National Unique Identification System, Aadhaar, has enrolled 1.3 billion persons. This, coupled with 1.2 billion mobile phones and opening of bank accounts for 440 million unbanked persons, has given a big boost for India's financial inclusion agenda. Our Universal Payments Interface, UPI, has enabled 4,186 million transactions amounting to rupees 7.6 trillion during last month. India is also a home of very strong startup and innovator community, and we are closely working with them to solve technological challenges to attain the sustainable development goals. WTF, PF provides a good platform for deliberation of new and innovative ideas and building a broad consensus on policies. Draft opinions generated by the informal expert group complement the efforts for sustainable development as envisaged by the WSIS. Draft opinions on artificial intelligence, Internet of Things, 5G, big data, OTTs, etc., are very relevant, needing due consideration from all. These technologies should address societal challenges faced by citizens in finance, agriculture, health, and education in delivering excellent social and economic returns. India believes that new technologies must address digital inclusion effectively, which is crucial for financial and economic inclusion of the poor and vulnerable. The report placed by the Secretary General will help all nations in formulating enabling policies and appropriate adoption of the new and emerging technologies to attain the sustainable development goals. India assures ITU of its support and looks forward to constructive deliberations during the coming 3 days. Thank you.